thanks for the patience. Hello, everyone. I'm Han Zhang from Rutgers University, and my advisor is Dimitri Maxis. I'm very pleased to talk about our work on STAT-GAN, text-to-photorealistic image synthesis. So, what is text-to-image synthesis? As you can see from this slide, given a sentence which briefly introduces the appearance information of the object, the goal is to automatically draw a set of images conditioned on the text. Here I mix the generated photos with the real ones. Can you guess which ones are generated? Which ones are the real? Hope most of you get your answers. Let's look at the correct one together. As you can see, among all these images, only two of them are the real photos. The rest are generated by our STAT-GAN. Actually, before STAT-GAN, there are several papers has already using GAN for text-to-image synthesis. The word by Scott is the first one to use GAN for text-to-image generation task, and they succeed in generating 64 by 64 images. But their generated image usually lack the details. As a follow-up work, GWWN is able to generate 128 by 128 image using more user annotations, such as object part locations. However, due to the unstable training behavior of GAN, it is very hard for the previous models to generate higher resolution image. To address this challenge, we first propose a two-stage stack generative adversarial networks for text-to-image synthesis. Later on, we have proposed a multi-stage advanced generative adversarial networks for both conditional and unconditional image generation. Obviously, our STAT-GAN is based on the GAN framework. Since Ian has already gave a very good introduction about GAN, I'll skip the backgrounds. But it's worth to mention that for conditional image generation, the generator and the discriminator both need to receive additional conditioning variable. Here, the discriminator D tries to distinguish the real pairs. So in the rest of this talk, I'll talk about the details for STAT-GAN and STAT-GAN 2. In the end of this talk, I will discuss a follow-up work that is based on the STAT-GAN framework. So the intuition behind STAT-GAN is try to mimic human painters to draw an image through a sketch refinement process. As shown here, given a sentence description, our stage one GAN first sketch the rough shape and basic color of the object. And then the stage two GAN scale it up to generate a higher resolution image with photorealistic details. Here is the overview of our STAT-GAN. It has three major components: the conditioning augmentation, stage one GAN, and stage two GAN. Next, I'll walk through each component. First, as the startup pipeline, given a text description, a global sentence embedding is first extracted from a pre-trained text encoder, such as character-level ConvNet. However, this text embedding is usually high-dimensional. Given limited amount of training data, it usually causes discontinuity in the latent data manifold, which is not desirable for learning the generator. To mitigate this problem, we propose conditioning augmentation. That is, instead of directly using the deterministic text embedding, we sample the conditioning variable from a Gaussian distribution, where the mean and the standard deviation are both functions of the text embedding. As shown here, a fully connected layer is first built to compute the mean and the standard deviation. And then we sample the conditioning variable from using the reparameterization trick. These techniques allow small perturbations along the conditioning manifold, thus produce more training samples given limited amount of image text pairs. Once we get the conditioning variable, we can use it to feed through the stage one GAN to generate the low resolution image. As shown in this slide, the conditioning variable is first contaminated with the noise vector, and then reshaped into 2D space and fed through a series of upsampling blocks to get the 64 by 64 images. And the discriminator takes the image and fed through a series of downsampling blocks to get the image feature, and then concatenate it with the text feature and fed through more convolutions to get the decision score. During training, we minimize equation 3 and equation 4 alternately. After the training, stage 1 GAN is able to generate low resolution images. However, the generated image usually have shape distortions, may also contain some, like, may lack some object parts. So the stage 2 GAN is built on stage 1 GAN to generate higher resolution image with better image quality. So first, our stage 2 GAN takes the stage 1 result and feeds through several downsampling blocks to extract the useful image features. In addition, we also input the text embedding to the stage 2 generator. With the stage 1 GAN. By doing this, the stage 2 generator is able to extract complementary information that is omitted by the stage 1 GAN. Once we get the new conditioning variable, we spatially replicated and concatenated with the image feature along the channel dimension, and fed through a series of residue blocks to learn the multimodal representations across the image and the text. Finally, we fed through this new feature vector to a series of upsampling blocks to generate 256 by 256 images. The discriminator of the stage 2 GAN is very similar to the stage 1 GAN with actual downsampling blocks, since the image resolution is larger in this stage. So in the end, the stage 2 GAN is able to crack the defects, complete the details, and produce photorealistic images with 4 times higher resolution. Although StagGAN has achieved the state-of-the-art result, it still has some problems. For example, it is not an end-to-end learning framework. If the stage 1 GAN completely fails in a collapsed mode, the stage 2 GAN could not correct the defects. So recently, we have proposed a new method. We observed that the natural images can be modeled at different stage scales or modeled with or without conditions. By jointly modeling multiple distributions, it will add more regularizations to each subtask and thus stabilize the training. So in the StagGAN 2 framework, we break the difficult generative task into subproblems with progressive goals. For example, we jointly model a series of low to high dimensional data distributions. Compared to StagGAN, StagGAN 2 has several advantages, including end-to-end training, more stable training behavior, and better generated images. Here is the overall architecture about StagGAN 2. As you can see, it consists of multiple generators and discriminators in a chain-like structure. As an advanced version of StagGAN, it explores 2 types of multi-distributions. One is multi-scale image distributions. The other is joint conditional and unconditional image distributions. As shown in this slide, the generators of StagGAN 2 share most of their parameters. The generator at the end of a chain has the final goal to generate a higher resolution image, while the generator at the intermediate branch has the progressive goals to generate small to large images. The whole framework is trained end to end. The positive feedback from learning one distribution is also helpful for learning the others. Our StagGAN 2 also jointly models unconditional image only distribution and conditional image distribution. The unconditional loss makes the generator generate realistic images, while the conditional loss helps the generator to generate image conditioned on the text. To sum up, our StackN2 is an end-to-end learning framework that jointly models multiple distributions. By doing this, it adds more regularizations and thus help the result and generate better samples. So far, I have discussed the details about StackN and StackN2. Next, I will show some experimental results. We validated our method on text-to-image generation task on three benchmark datasets. We also generalized it for the unconditional image generation to generate bedroom, church, dog, and cats. For evaluation, we adopt the inception score and the human rank as the evaluation metric. As you can see from this table, our StackN achieves the state-of-the-art result on all three datasets for text-to-image generation. Compared to all the baseline models, our StackN for the first time generates 256 by 256 photorealistic images from text descriptions. Here, it shows the difference between the stage one images and the stage two images. In this example, with the satisfactory stage one result, stage two can focus on drawing the short beak and the white color described in the text, as well as the details for the tails and legs. And also, if the StackN result has some errors, stage two GAN is able to correct those defects by processing the text description again. Here is the example. When the stage one image has a blue crown rather than the reddish crown in the text, this defect is corrected by the stage two GAN. In some cases, if stage one GAN fails to draw a plausible shape, stage two GAN is able to generate some reasonable objects. Generally speaking, the stage one GAN image usually have rough shapes and colors of the object, while the stage two image add more convincing details to better reflect the corresponding text descriptions. To validate the design of our StackN work, we also conduct some elevation studies. As shown in this example, here we don't use the condition augmentation. Even here, we use different noise vector. The stage one GAN collapse to be meaningless samples. But when we use the condition augmentation, we can see that here we fix the noise vector. But you can see we still generate birds from different points, from different viewpoints and different like shapes. Clearly, StackN is better than the one-stage GAN by processing the text information again. Here is another example. To validate our StackN learns a smooth latent data manifold rather than simply memorizing the training samples, we have used it to generate images from linearly interpolated sentences. As you can see from this example, the generated samples clearly reflect the color changes in the text, as well as maintain a reasonable bird shape. And we have done another experiment. In this experiment, we retrieve the top five nearest neighbor of the generated samples in the training set. By visualizing these images, we can see that the generated samples, which is in the left column, has shared some character characteristics with the images in the training set, but they are essentially different. From these two examples, it proves that our StackN achieved good results, not by simply memorizing the training samples. So far, we have seen like the StackN is able to generate very good samples, but it still has some failure cases. The main reason for this failure is that the stage one GAN fails in a collapsed mode, so the stage two GAN is not able to correct those errors, as shown in the left figure and in the right rectangle. But compared to the StackN, StackN2 don't have the collapsed mode in our visualization. We believe that by jointly approximating multiple distributions, it helps, it adds more regularizations and helps learning for each task. Here we visualize the generated image using the T-Scene and embed the generated image in a 2D space. We also generalize our StackN2 for unconditional image generation task. Here are the examples for different datasets. It turns out that our StackN2 is able to generate high quality image in different scenarios. Next, I want to discuss a follow-up work we did that is built on the StackN framework. In all the previous text-to-image, GAN-based text-to-image generation tasks, they're always using the global sentence embedding. But this has one potential drawback is that they omit the world-level information, which could be useful for generating more vivid images. So in this attention GAN framework, we add attention mechanism into the GAN and let the stage GAN to automatically select the conditions during the generation. The key idea is that it's still like a StackN framework. In the first stage, it still used the global sentence embedding. But in the following stages, it used the generated image to query the word vectors, and then use the queried word vectors and the image feature in that specific location to generate the images in the surrounding location. By visualizing the attentions for different stages, we for the first time proves that the staged generative adversarial networks is able to automatically choose the conditions during the training. And this work was jointly did with collaborators in Microsoft Research. To sum up, in this work, we proposed stack generative adversarial networks for synthesizing high-resolution photorealistic images. The two-stage StackN decomposes the text-to-image synthesis into a novel sketch refinement process, while the multi-stage StackN jointly models multiple related distributions to stabilize the training and further improve the quality of the generated samples. As a follow-up work, AttentionGAN is built on our StackN, and it proposes an attention mechanism for generative networks, which enables to generate images through interpretable steps. At last, I want to thank all the contributors to our StackN work. And thanks for listening. Also, our code is available online. And in this SCCV, we have a poster session and an oral session later at 27th. Thanks for the listening. I'm happy to take any questions. Any questions? Yeah. Yeah, actually, those Laplacian GANs is the, like, this before us actually is provide some motivations for the stack GAN. Like, in the Laplacian GAN, they also like try to generate image through like stages, but they are built their own framework in Laplacian Gaussian pyramid framework. But in our case, we just directly transfer the low resolution image to a higher resolution image. So it turns out in this way, it can be easily to generate a better image. And it seems like the architecture is simpler compared to the Laplacian GAN. Yeah, the question is that for the StackN2, have we tried to use like feed the like the generated image into the like more upper stages, right? So like this is like this is the architecture for our StackN2. Instead of using that, we directly use the intermediate feature vector to generate to use that to upscale to generate a larger image feature vector. It turns out this design is helpful. It's better than like directly fast through the generated image and then do downsampling and then upsampling to generate the like a later stage image. And this one is simpler, and it turns out the result is better than the other alternatives. For the tricks, I think it's worth to mention that I think several things. First, for the text embedding, if you directly use that, that is not very good. You get very like sparse space for the conditioning variable. So to solve this, we use the conditioning augmentation. That is like to allow small perturbations. This is like one important thing to mention. The other important thing that, for example, in the state game, the stage two first use the downsampling blocks to like first encode the image. If we directly use the generated image and fast through residue blocks and upsampling, the result is not very good. Like it's hard to correct those defects. And also the residue blocks is very important. The residue blocks learns the multimodal relationship between image and text. And the number of residue blocks is a hyperparameter we need to tune for different data sets. And if you add too many residue blocks, that would change the stage two result will be very different from stage one result. But it's just like how more parameters and it's hard to train. But if you add various like one layer of residue blocks, you can find that it's hard to correct those defects. So those are the things we learned from like playing with the code. One more question.
Nobody has a last question. I'll clear one up for you. Which of the different losses for the generator is worth best for you?
Basically, I just take the loss you used in your work. Okay. Yeah. Without like one minus, it's just like negative D, log D.
Negative log D.
Yeah. Actually, for the losses, I probably make an advertisement. In a new work I done with during our internship in OpenAI, we have come up with a new like loss function. It turns out it greatly stables the training of GANs. Yeah, and we will submit this work into the probably like this workshop or iClear.